The Radioactive Waste Treatment and Disposal Facility, RWTDF, was established in 1976. At first, all low and intermediate level radioactive waste from the country was transported here. Since 1998, the facility has been operated by the Public Limited Company for Radioactive Waste Management, PURAM. Only institutional radioactive waste, waste of non-nuclear power plant origin, is disposed of in the facility. The near-surface repository is situated on the border of Püspökszilágy and Kisnémedi, with a disposal capacity of 5,000 cubic meters. In the RWTDF, 74 reinforced concrete vaults and 36 carbon steel, stainless steel wells serve the placement of radioactive waste. Steady development and modernization ensure safe acceptance of radioactive waste for further decades. Low and intermediate level radioactive waste from various institutions of Hungary is treated, stored, or disposed of by the facility. The waste includes, for example, used radiation sources from industry and healthcare, as well as contaminated equipment, clothes such as gloves of researchers who work with isotopes. In most cases, transport too is carried out by PURAM. Then the incoming material is treated, stored, or disposed of, depending on the type of the waste. Beyond the basic activity, continuous safety and environmental monitoring is also the task of the operators, together with the development and modernization of the technical equipment and the built environment. Low and intermediate level radioactive waste is produced in many areas, such as healthcare, research, agriculture, and industry. The contaminated materials, such as working tools, coveralls, and various substances, get into drums or containers and are finally placed in reinforced concrete vaults. Close radiation sources used for different measurements, examinations, or curing are stored in wells. That is also valid for radiation sources from therapeutic irradiators or smoke detectors. In most cases, transportation is carried out by the well-trained personnel of PURAM. They arrive at a pre-arranged time at the facility that produces the waste. The reception of the waste is regulated by strict safety standards. The facility handing over the waste awaits the vehicle and its personnel, then in a closed collecting area delivers the waste, which in our case is stored in standardized, qualified drums. The operator of PURAM controls the packaging, marks it with an identification code, and then lifts it into the transport vehicle. After stabilizing the package and filling in the documents, the vehicle also gets a distinguishing sign to be allowed to participate in traffic. High-level radiation sources are placed in a special radiation-shielded container before being placed on a transport vehicle. Before entering the RWTDF, everybody has to pass a very strict security check. First, the vehicle passes through the radiation detector portal, which measures the radiation on its surface. When the waste arrives, it is unloaded in the operational building, and the drums receive unique identification codes. The drums are carried to the place of the interim storage in transportation frames. Incoming waste is classified according to its quantity, physical form, and the nature of the radiation, its characteristics determining how it is treated. Among the materials to be treated, there are a large number of tools and coveralls with radioactive contamination. This kind of waste arrives at the facility in special drums. The amount of used radiation sources and the isotopes is much lower. They are transported in special containers and placed in non-corrosive steel wells for interim storage. The work begins with sorting, during which the level of radiation, the properties of the material, and several other factors are examined. Some of the necessary measurements are performed in the lab of the facility. For ideal space management, the repacked waste is compressed. A heavy-duty pressing machine is used for this purpose, which can reduce volume to 1/5 of the original. Treated waste is placed in standard drums, identified in accordance with regulations, and registered before storage or disposal. The used closed radiation sources are treated in a hot cell cabin. The working processes are carried out behind radiation-shielded walls and windows. The operators use robot arms, manipulators, in a safe, closed system. The precision instrument can carry over the motion of the human arm. One can grip and work with them precisely. Closed radiation sources are packed in non-corrosive steel casings, torpedoes, which are hermetically closed with welding already in the hot cell. As mentioned, some parts of the waste are stored in the technological building only provisionally. The final disposal of low and intermediate radioactive waste packed in drums takes place in near-surface concrete vaults. The interim storage of torpedoes takes place outside or in the operational building in non-corrosive steel wells sunk several meters deep underground. At each step of material handling, storage, preparatory work, safety, and precision are primary considerations. Long-term safe operation was a fundamental aspect at the early stages of site selection. It is also guaranteed by continuous environmental monitoring. At multiple locations, the level and cleanliness of groundwater, as well as soil erosion, are monitored by the staff. More than 2,000 samples are collected and measured every year in the living and inanimate environment of the facility and its exclusion zone. From the beginning of spring to the end of autumn, a sheep flock, like a living lawnmower, takes care of the plants of the RWTDF, and they are also part of the environmental monitoring. The healthy flora and fauna in the environment of the RWTDF provides evidence of responsible and safe operation.